In this video, you'll learn a very fast trick to make the colors pop in Photoshop. I'm gonna demonstrate this using the Channel Mixer adjustment layer. But before that, here is what happens in Photoshop when you want to increase the saturation or vibrance on a JPEG photo. If you use the vibrance adjustment layer, the saturation is increased, but the final look is not saturated that much, even though the slider is at the maximum value. Let's delete this and try with the hue saturation adjustment layer. When I increase the saturation slider value, I start to see artifacts and banding at 80%. It looks horrible and unnatural, so again, I will delete this. By adding a channel mixer adjustment layer, you're gonna have to deal with the RGB channels separately, but it's nothing too complicated. Besides, you want to have the best result, so it's worth it. The red, the green, and the blue with their combined values are creating the final look in the image, but here is the trick. The values of each slider can go up to 200% instead of 100, the maximum value for the vibrance and saturation. The only thing you have to keep in mind is that if you want to have a balanced image in terms of colors, if you add up the values of the three sliders on each channel, this value right here should be around 100. In this image, I want to increase the reds and the yellows to have a more saturated sunlight. So first, I select the red channel. I increase the red value to 200%, and for the green and blue, I write in minus 50. This way, the total value stays at 100 units. I switch to the blue channel. I enter 200 for the blue and minus 50 for the red and green sliders. For the green channel, I enter 200 for the green slider, minus 50 for the red, and for the blue, I grab the slider and bring it to minus 30 only, because otherwise, I will insert too much magenta, and for this photo, I don't feel like it's necessary. If this is too saturated for you, you can always lower the opacity of the slider if you want. Let's see the difference now between using vibrance, hue saturation, and the channel mixer. Leave a comment and tell me which one do you like more. Let's choose another example where we have some daylight with grass, clothes, and even skin. Actually, this is a really awesome photo. You'll find the link to download the image in the description of the video. So if I would simply use a hue saturation layer and try to raise the saturation to 60, for example, you can clearly see that it doesn't look that good. You start to see some really weird colors in the greens, like here, for example. Also, the red areas were not affected too much on her clothes. So let's get rid of this layer, add a channel mixer instead, and apply the same settings like before. Red channel, 200% for red, minus 50 for green and blue. Green channel, 200 for the green, minus 50 for red and blue. And the last one, the blue channel, 200 for blue and minus 50 for red and green. This is how to make your colors pop in Photoshop. Look at the before and after here. Amazing results, and this is the difference between hue saturation and the channel mixer. Amazing result. I hope you enjoyed this. If you don't want to miss any of my future tutorials, make sure you hit the subscribe, the bell, and see you next time. I'm Chris. Bye-bye now.